हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, एनपी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस द प्रिपरेशन प्रॉपर्टीज एंड यूजेस ऑफ नाइट्रोजन एंड वी सॉल्व सम प्रॉब्लम्स विच आर लॉजिकल प्रॉब्लम्स इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर. नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस द कंपाउंड्स ऑफ नाइट्रोजन. सो लेट अस फर्स्ट लिस्ट डाउन द कंपाउंड्स ऑफ नाइट्रोजन. And the compounds of nitrogen, first one is the ammonia. It is the hydride of nitrogen and its formula is NH3. Second one is the oxides of nitrogen. And we know the varieties of oxides are there N2O, NO, NO2, N2O3, N2O4 and N2O5. Third one is the oxo acids of nitrogen, and the oxo acids of nitrogen are two. First one is the HNO3 nitric acid and second one is the HNO2 nitrous acid. So for all these compounds we have to discuss the question in a sequence. Give preparation properties and uses of ammonia. For all the oxides we have to prepare some oxides, not all oxides, and the resonance structures of oxides, Lewis structures of oxide, their 3D shape also. Oxo acid in which we have to prepare this nitric acid. So let us start today only preparation of ammonia. Properties and uses we will discuss later on. So write down first question in your book. Give different methods of preparation of ammonia, NH3. So first, naturally ammonia is prepared by decay of urea with the help of moisture of soil. So first write down the formula of urea. This is the urea, NH2CONH2 urea, solid, already moisture present in the soil, and when urea react with the moisture, two nitrogen are there, so it gives two moles of ammonia. But first intermediate compound is formed from this urea, and this one is the moisture present in a soil. We get first ammonium carbonate, and this ammonium carbonate by decomposition we get two moles of ammonia, plus this carbonate gives us a carbon dioxide gas, and number of hydrogen gives half number of water molecules. Six used here, total 8 hydrogen, 2 plus 2 and 2. So here is the 2 water molecule is obtained, and we require, balance it yourself, okay, 2 moles of ammonia or 2 moles of water required. See, this ammonia and moisture by decomposition gives the ammonium carbonate. It gives 2 moles ammonia, carbon dioxide and water. Okay, reaction is important. Balance it by trial and error method. Second method is by, this is the laboratory method, lab method. In a laboratory it is obtained by reaction of ammonium salt. And ammonium salts are two, One is the ammonium chloride and second one is the ammonium sulfate, NH4 twice, SO4. By using this ammonium salt with either lime water formula is CaOH twice, or with sodium hydroxide, and it is called caustic soda, and formula is NaOH, sodium hydroxide. Listen, my friend, never prepare a balanced reaction from textbook. Always first write down a rough reaction and then balance each and every atom by trial and error method. If redox reaction is there, then by redox reaction method. Okay, so let us write first. See, first ammonium salt is a NH4Cl. NH4Cl when react with a lime water, CaOH twice. See, when metal and negative ion of group number 17 is there, this calcium and this chloride, it form a calcium chloride salt, CaCl2. So here we require two chlorine, so here two NH4Cl, here is two nitrogen, so we will get two moles of ammonia gas, and remaining hydrogen gives a half number of water molecule. See, here we used 2, 3, 6 hydrogen, and here total we have 8 and to 10 hydrogen. Out of 10 hydrogen, 6 are used here, so remaining 4 gives a 2 water molecules. Already balanced reaction. Ammonium sulfate salt, NH4 twice SO4, when react with a sodium hydroxide, this sodium and sulfate gives sodium sulfate, and its formula is Na2SO4, and is 2 Na required, so here we require 2 NaOH. 2 nitrogen gives us 2 moles of ammonia, 2 moles of ammonia, plus number of hydrogen gives half number of water molecule, or remaining number of oxygen gives the same number of water molecule. See here, how many hydrogen we used? 6 hydrogen used, and how many hydrogen present here? 4 to 8, 8 n plus 2, 10 are present. So out of 10, 6 used here, so 2 moles of water molecules are obtained. So by this technique, you can solve. Here also this is not, I think, a balanced reaction, so try to balance it yourself. See here, and 2 hydrogen, total 6 hydrogens are here, and here 8 hydrogens are produced. So to balance, write down here 2 water molecule. Now 2 plus 2, 4 and 4, 8 balanced. Now further decomposition of this ammonium carbonate gives 2 moles of ammonia. This carbonate is converted into carbon dioxide, and remaining hydrogen gives a half number of water molecule. Okay, so out of 8, 6 used in ammonia, okay, 2 remain, so it gives 1 water molecule. Second is a lab method. Okay, third method is the industrial method. Let us discuss the industrial method. You know very well, industrial method is, third one is industrial method. And industrially it is prepared by Haber's process. So in Haber process, 1 mole of nitrogen reacts with 3 moles of hydrogen, and the conditions are in presence of Fe2O3 catalyst at 773 Kelvin temperature, 200 bar pressure, and promoters are also here, but that we will discuss in the description. The 1:3 proportion of nitrogen gas and hydrogen gas in presence of this catalyst at this temperature, at this pressure, we get 2 moles of ammonia. And this process is a exothermic process. So delta H is negative. Delta H is negative. In olden time, Fe used as a catalyst. Fe used as a catalyst and molybdenum, MO, molybdenum was used as promoter. Promoter is also called catalyst. It activates the catalyst, but both are very costly. So finally the ammonia produces also becomes very costly. So nowadays Fe2O3 is used as catalyst and either K2O, potassium oxide or aluminium oxide is used as promoter. According to Le Chatelier's principle, see, in 11th standard we studied Le Chatelier principle. See, 1 mole and 3 mole, total 4 mole gives us a 2 mole. So, forward direction the gaseous mole decreases. So, in this reaction, pressure decreases. So, according to Le Chatelier's principle, increase in pressure is favorable for forward direction reaction when equilibrium established, means at equilibrium. Another thing, according to Le Chatelier's principle, LCP, according to Le Chatelier's principle, see, process is exothermic. So process is exothermic. So lowering in temperature is favorable for forward direction reaction to get better yield, means to get more and more ammonia. It is necessary that continuously react proceed in a forward direction. So better thing according to Le Chatelier's principle is a higher pressure is maintained here 200 bar, and another thing is the lower temperature is favorable for forward direction to get better yield, or we can say better product. But one problem arises here. According to chemical kinetics, lowering in temperature decreases the rate of reaction. What chemical kinetics says, if you lower the temperature, then this rate of reaction decreases. So to overcome the problem of chemical kinetics, to overcome the problems of Le Chatelier's principle and chemical kinetics. क्या प्रॉब्लम है दोनों का? Le Chatelier's principle says decrease in temperature favorable for forward direction. What chemical kinetics says? Decrease in temperature will decrease the rate of reaction. So one says decrease in temperature will gives more product. Chemical kinetics says decrease in temperature gives less product. So whenever in chemistry this type of problem arises, at that time optimum state is decided. So to overcome the problems of Le Chatelier's principle and chemical kinetic, optimum state is decided. My dear friends, optimum states means here the problem of chemical kinetic also solved and problem of Le Chatelier also solved. So let us note down the optimum states. For optimum states is a temperature is a 773 Kelvin, pressure is a 200 bar, catalyst is Fe2O3, promoters are, see, catalyst and promoters I have noted here. Whenever you are asked which of the following is optimum state, then you have to write only temperature and pressure. This temperature overcome the problem of Le Chatelier and also overcome the problem of chemical kinetics of the lowering in a rate of reaction. And promoters are either K2O or Al2O3. After this, I will explain you the flow chart of Haber process of ammonia that you don't have to draw in exam. But for explanation how ammonia is produced by Haber process, that I will explain you the next in next lecture, and then we will start the properties and uses of ammonia. Okay, thank you friends, thank you very much.